Good afternoon. I am Carol Burton, and I have the privilege to serve Western Carolina University as acting provost this year. On behalf of Interim Chancellor Morrison Shetler, welcome to our ceremony in honor of the Cherokee heritage and of student learning. As many of you know, the heritage and tradition of a proud people permeate the very ground upon which our university is built. It is essential that Western Carolina University explore and enhance our relationship with the Eastern Band of the Cherokee Indian and continue to educate our students, our faculty, our staff, and our community about the Cherokee people, culture, and the significance of this beautiful place that we call home. Our 2017-18 campus theme, Cherokee, Community, Culture, Connections, was selected to honor this rich and diverse culture. Campus themes constitute one example of a high-impact educational practice that provides students with common and collaborative educational experiences, opportunities to connect curricular and co-curricular learning, and explorations of disciplines through a common lens. For the past 8 years, WCU has selected an interdisciplinary theme to promote campus conversations and educational enrichment. I believe that the 2017-18 campus theme focusing on Cherokee was one of our most successful yet, and I would like to recognize Dr. Lisa Bloom, who was chair of our committee. She's in the front somewhere, Lisa. As well as the other members of the committee for their work last year in promoting and supporting the theme. I'd also like to recognize Sky Sampson, director of our Cherokee Center. Is Sky here? There she is. Dr. Brett Riggs, the Sequoia Distinguished Professor of Cherokee Studies. And Dr. Ben Steer, director of our Cherokee Studies program. I have been honored to witness, and I hope in some small way to facilitate the continued growth and strengthening of our relationship with the Eastern Band of the Cherokee Indian. And now it is my distinct pleasure to welcome Richard Sneed, Principal Chief of the Eastern Band of the Cherokee Indians, to the podium.
Thank you again. Thanks so much. Shiona gada, wena ia snidi dagwado. Hello, everyone. My name is Richard Sneed. I'm the Principal Chief of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, and it is my distinct honor to stand before you today. For thousands of years, our people dwelled on these lands where this campus is housed today. And for many centuries, after European contact, there was a concerted effort to extinguish and even wipe out the memory of Native nations across this country. I'm humbled and honored that Western Carolina University has seen fit over the last year and in previous years to take a completely different stand, and that is to enhance the relationship that exists with the tribe, to enhance the recognition of Cherokee culture and tradition on these very lands where this campus is. Not far from here is Judicullah Rock. And for years, I always wondered, what does Judicullah mean? And then Tom Belt did an interpretation of Judicullah Wee, the land where Judicullah is from, or the place of Judicullah. And that's where Cullowee gets its name from, is from Judicullah. In Cherokee legends, a giant who can consume the rivers in one drink, who gave us the rules and how we should interact with nature and hunting laws and so forth. And so it is an honor to be here today on behalf of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians at this unveiling, where this sculpture will, for generations to come, be a marker and a reminder to all of the students and faculty who come through the courtyard that this land was Cherokee land first and will always be Cherokee land. But it is our honor to share with Western Carolina University this land so that education of future generations can take place. I I want to thank Skye Sampson for all the work that she does at Cherokee Center. I noticed when Dr. Burton recognized her earlier, she was extremely embarrassed that she was being recognized. So I want to recognize you again and put you on the spot for all the great work that you do. And Dr. Riggs, for the work that you do with the Cherokee Center and the advisory board, thank you very much, sir, for your commitment to ensuring that our story is told in a culturally appropriate manner and that it's historically accurate as well. Thank you to Tom Belt and everybody who works in the Cherokee Language and Cherokee Studies program to ensure that our language is preserved. We're so blessed that we had a language that was written down and so it can be preserved. And this sculpture is a representation of that, as you will see. And so I'm grateful to Tom for his work on this and his vision for this project. And I promised Dr. Burton I would stick with the 5 B's of public speaking. Be brief, brother, be brief. So with that, I will yield. And who am I calling up next? Dr. Riggs, if you would.
Chief Snead is always a hard act to follow. And I saw with some trepidation that I was lined up behind him in the order of speaking, but I will do what I can here. So not to give anything away before the curtain is drawn here, but what the symbol that is here is from the Cherokee syllabary, the Cherokee writing system, and it represents the phoneme we, which is used in many different ways in Cherokee. But if you use it by itself, it's a word. It's a word. Now, we've seen this as a joyous exclamation on innumerable bumper stickers as you drive around town, you know, that celebrate Western Carolina as we. But the meaning of that is much, much deeper. You know, in the Cherokee language, we is a locative. It means the place of something or someone. So right here, we could be Catamount We, but we're actually in a very special place that is Kulawi. And that's a contraction of Jutkalawi, the place of Jutukala. And you know, we just take that for granted as the place we live in, but it means we are in a place of greatness here. Jutkala was a great immortal being who preceded all of us here. He was a steward. He was the maintainer of the natural world. So when we arrived, we were just freshmen. We didn't know anything. And Jutkala took pity on us and taught us about the natural order of all things before he left these mountains. So it is that we're here in what was already a seat of higher learning. At the first seat of higher learning, the place of Jutkala, who is the great teacher. We're in his we. Now, Kulawi or Jutkalawi refers to the entire valley, the whole place. This particular we, where we are, where we now stand, is also the site of an ancient Cherokee town. This was and still is Dalajishkwayi or Dalajishkawi, the place of two sparrows. The mound that was the seat of the temple and the sacred fire was just a few feet away from here where Killian now stands. Traditional histories mark this as the first Cherokee town in the Tuckasegee River Valley, a most sacred place because the surrounding hills resound with the songs and dances of the immortals, the people to whom Jutkala was kin. Archaeological excavations right out here where you are, and ongoing right now where Niggly Theater was, reveal traces of that ancient town that are buried beneath our feet. So it's still here. It's still here. It hasn't left. This spot, this we, remains very much part of the Cherokee world. Western Carolina now celebrates this heritage, this legacy of Jutkala, the great teacher, with this, what, as you will see, beautiful sculpture of Cherokee syllabary character for we. This installation serves to remind us constantly that this place, Western Carolina University, Dalajishkwayi Kulawi Jutkalawi, has the deepest roots and we have responsibility to this place and its mission as the original seat of the great teacher. I want to thank Todd Martin for the beautiful design that you will see. And I want to thank the WCU Cherokee Theme Year Committee for helping make this symbol a reality so that we can all remember for all time where we are and why we're here. So, we.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for being here today. I'm Todd Martin. I'm in my last semester in the Fine Arts program here at Western. And this project started kind of in an untraditional way. I approached the school theme committee about a year ago now, and asked them for some money to do a artwork based on the school theme, community, Cherokee community culture connections. And so by the theme committee choosing to invest in me and my vision, I was able to create this project that focused a lot on engagement and also gave me a lot of learning experience. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about that now. So in the research phase of this project, I was working with another graduate student at the time, Brendan Best. And we were researching, looking for ideas for this project. And we came across we, the Cherokee syllabary character. And we became really enamored with this symbol because it's such a beautiful symbol and it has such a strong story and such a strong connection to Kulawi. And we got really excited about it and we started to design the proposal and the sculpture based on this symbol. And as we were doing that, more and more people became interested. And I was also able to write a grant to receive more funding. The College of Fine and Performing Arts, Dean George Brown became very interested and also provided some funding. And that really helped to take this project to a level that I never imagined was possible. And so after Brendan and I designed this proposal, we were really excited. And one day I called Ben Steer and I was on the phone talking to him. I was so excited. I was asking him questions and I was telling him about the project. And Ben goes, well, hold on a second, Todd. You do realize that you're a white guy trying to throw up this 9 foot tall Cherokee symbol. And That was a reality. But then he said, that's okay though. Come and meet with all of us and we can do this the proper way, the right way. And so after that, I went and I met with the folks in the Cherokee Studies program, Tom, Brett, Ben, Sarah, Sky. And right away I could tell how passionate all of these people were about their program, how passionate they were about their culture and this project. And also they're really excited about this re-education of the place of Kulawi. And I'll never forget when I left that meeting, Tom Belt, he looked at me and he said, if they tell you you can only make the sculpture this tall, I want you to make it this tall. And I really took that to heart. And their enthusiasm really gave me the confidence to complete this project. And so I thank all of you in the program in Sky and the Cherokee Center. And so after those meetings, I began gathering materials to begin the fabrication. And so here's a little tip for any students who want to do a project. There's these things called purchase orders and budget codes. And if you try to buy thousands of dollars of steel without permission, it creates an accounting nightmare. So learning experience there. And then during fabrication, I got to spend a lot of time in the UNCA Steam Studio in Asheville, which is a state-of-the-art facility that has engineers and also artists working in a collaborative space. And their facility there, I really felt like I was a little boy in a candy shop, because there's just incredible technology and machines everywhere. And during the time working there, there was a team of artists and engineers fabricating a sculpture to be installed in New York Times Square. And so to be able to work in that space and work alongside those people was an experience that I will never forget. But also right here on campus in our sculpture studio, we did a lot of the fabrication. The concrete base that you see here, that was cast in our studio, and that was 950 pounds of concrete. And so 950 pounds of concrete takes a team of a lot of people to fabricate. And what was really neat, the day that I came in to make this, I was thinking, who can I ask to help me? And I just kind of started, and then all of a sudden, students, faculty, grad students, everyone just jumped right in. I didn't have to ask a single person to come and help me. And that's what I really love about the program and about Western, is the community atmosphere and everyone's willingness to help. And also during the entire course of the project, I worked with Tom Ashcraft and Morgan Kennedy. They're my faculty mentors. And I really learned a lot from them. I would spend all day and all night working on an aspect of the project. And Morgan would come in the next morning, take one look at it and go, huh, well, why didn't you do it this way? And I would go, oh man, yeah, I should have done it that way. And from that, I learned that even if you spend a long time creating a mistake, you can't be afraid to go back and fix it. And that became a really important lesson that will stay with me in future projects. And it also taught me a lot about perseverance, because there was times during this project where I really I doubted myself and I doubted my abilities. There was times I really asked myself, will I be able to pull this off? Will I be able to complete this project? And I don't think there was ever a second where Tom and Morgan ever doubted me, or there was never a time where they would ever let me give up or fail at this project. And for that, I want to thank both of you. So to conclude, I want to say that I think it's extremely important to keep investing in these student projects. I think we should fill the entire campus with engagement and with these student works. And when I leave Western, I get to say, look at what I created. And when new students come here, all of you get to say, look what we created. Look at what's possible. And that comes from the community and from the help that everyone has provided. So I think everyone should also congratulate themselves.
Thank you, Todd, for sharing your artwork and your story, your passion, your drive. You truly are inspiring to witness students develop a deep connection with and a commitment to their surrounding community. And I salute you, as we all do. A little known fact, Dr. Bloom is actually Todd's mother. It is her birthday today, and she can think of no greater gift. And Todd's father and other family members are here today, Tim, and so we welcome you all. The Cherokee have a rich artistic history spanning thousands of years, represented by traditional arts and crafts, as well as outstanding contemporary art, which they have committed to preserve and promote. Western Carolina University is proud to honor our Cherokee neighbors and friends with the dedication of this artwork today. And I thank all of the faculty and staff who continue to work with students to make this meaningful work continue. This concludes our program, and I invite you all to join us in Killian 102 behind me for some light refreshments and to engage in conversation with our special guests. Thank you again. If I could request that the speakers remain, and Todd's family will do some photo ops. Thanks, everyone. We appreciate your attendance.